this which we are celebrating,
yeah, it is
18th year of anniversary.
Mwaka gwa 18 ogwo kuyitibwa kwange.
I was called 2006.
Nayitibwa bidi mukaga.
That's when I started preaching the gospel.
Olwe natandika okubuulira enjiri.
I was very young.
Nali muto nnyo.
For the gospel.
Olwe enjiri.
You know the gospel, you meet many people.
Wanyo munjiri osinkana abantu bangi.
The old and the young.
Abakulu n'abato.
So I was young to teach to old people.
Kati nali muto nnyo okubuulira abantu abakulu.
So I was burning the charcoal. I was burning the charcoal. And I was burning the charcoal. I was with the Apostle Mark, he has gone out. And as we are burning the charcoal, the whole day we put in the fire couldn't burn. We did everything that we know, because in Kabale we do more charcoal. The fire couldn't burn. So when it had reached at 2, the fire was like slowing. Of course it couldn't burn. But then at that very moment, a wind came as if there was someone behind purposing that the fire should burn. And what we had tried to do, it couldn't work. But when that wind came, it burned the charcoal. So as I was still astonished, asking myself what has happened, I heard a voice which I had never heard in that wind. The voice said, remove your stone. I want to save you and use you. I couldn't understand the first time. The second time, it came, remove the stone, I want to save you and use you. I didn't know about the things of the spirit. I knew that even Israel is in heaven. I didn't know anything other than going in the church and dance like any other young child. But at that very moment, when the fire burned and that voice called the second time, I was sitting on a stone. I removed it and I threw it down. I knew that it would stop from there. But it shouted the more. What I did, I took off from the bush and I went home. When I reached home, because it was a strange experience of a 15-year-old boy, I covered myself with blankets, never to hear that voice in my ears. That voice entered in my stomach. And when it would speak, it would be as if it is a bass. And then the next day, my mother is here. The next day, there was a conference in Little
Kabarebe.
And that conference, there had come a white woman from Israel. So my mother said, let's go to the conference. And when we went to the conference, the woman started preaching, saying that she went to the tomb of Jesus Christ and the stone is rolled away. And then she started preaching. She said,
Nagamba,
some of you, God is rolling away the stones.
Katonda ayiringisa amayinja.
He want to use you.
Ayagala bakozesa.
At that very moment,
akasera ako,
I said maybe this is a white woman who fooled me.
Osango no ye muzungu yansanze mu lusozi
ayogala bino. I was attentive to listen to her.
Nafayo nyo kumuuliriza.
But I don't know what happened to me.
Nesimanyi chantukako.
I found myself on the stage.
Nesanga ku katuti.
And I didn't know what to say. They made me to confess Christ.
Banja tuzobulo kozi.
And from that day,
ero kubenoro na koro,
I realized
na chizuna nti,
that whenever I'll be moving somewhere,
duruwe mbatambula I want to wana,
I know things.
Manye bintu.
I look on someone.
Ntunulido omuntu.
And then sometimes I would feel maybe it is the thought.
Erebi sele bimuna roo zanganti ndo woza bulo woza.
Like you see someone and you hear like someone telling you beti 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 beti.
Beti 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 beti.
And then you're moving with someone you do not know.
Otambula no muntu gotambanyina yengebe byowulira mu munda
mu. But somehow somewhere you meet another person.
Nemo ngene mo benda no sinka no muntu omulala.
And when you meet another person he confirms say, "Oh, how are you Beti?"
Era wo sinka no muntu omulala nakakasanuka, "Toli otya Beti?"
Say, hey, I knew this name.
I started
seeing many things. I started seeing many things. And that's how I was called into ministry. I preached in the Church of Uganda. I visited more than 97 churches. Preaching the gospel. Many churches I went with other people. There is someone here called Pastor Spencer. He's the one who led a team called Tuliomurugendo. He was still in the Church of Uganda. And then he took me through the gospel. Would walk long distances.
Twatambulanga ebanga epanvu awante wala.
But I desired to know the power of God.
Nene gombo kumanya amanyi ga Katonda.
Though I would be moving with them, they would be preaching.
Newankubadde natambulanga nabonga babuulira.
But when I would see a lame person.
Bwenalaba ngomulema.
But when I would see a lame person.
Bwenalaba ngomulema.
Oh, I see someone who has a problem.
Oba bwenalaba ngomuntu alina ekizibu.
I would feel that that problem should be solved.
Nawuliranga nti ekizibu ekyo kiteekeddwa okugonjoolwa.
And then it took me whenever I go to preach to be fasting.
Oro kyantwalira okusibanga.
Whenever I go to preach.
Buli lwe twagendanga okubuuliranga nina kuba nasiibye.
And I started seeing God.
Era natandika okulaba Katonda.
That time I was in senior 1. So in that senior 1, there is one experience that I got. I was fasting. My life has been full of fasting. I started fasting. I was fasting for 5 days a week. So now when I was fasting, I passed one place. And I found 5,000. And the next day, the voice told me, pass to the other place. Again, I found 5,000. The third day, the voice told me, go and pass the other place. And it was like a roundabout, those who know Kabarebe. It's called Eso.
I
passed 5 times.
Naita
finding 5,000 every evening. And inside me there was a motivation, go and eat very well. Because 5,000 by that time it was enough for me. In that same year, I was passing somewhere going to the toilet, and then I found a lady on the junction, a lady, and then when I was passing she fell down, and she started shouting, you're burning me, you're destroying me. And I looked at her, I couldn't understand. And You know, it was an amazing life. I can't speak all. I would look, it is a boy who prophesied in senior one again. I saw him.
Namulaba.
He used to sleep in the classroom. And I said, you have a witchcraft on your panty.
Ne mugamba sebo ina yirizimu underwear yo.
He looked at him and he couldn't.
Yatunuliranga tachikiriza nangambona ningiza atya.
And I told him that when you the time you're coming to school.
Ne namugamba takasera woje kusomero.
Your mother gave it to you to tie it on your panty.
Mama we akakuoka sibe mu underwear mukapanti mukalya eri akatini.
And went to the dormitories and burnt it.
Ne agena mutombo ne nkocha.
So from that time, I started seeing an amazing life. I can't tell, I can't speak. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me speak this, then I will thank you, and then I do some small things, then we go.
Kanjogere chino orunkola kakatakatono mbasime tugende.
This is an experience of senior 5.
Chino chaliwo chenje chena itamu musini yokutano.
In senior 4, the power became so strong.
Musini yokuna manji gafuka manji nyo.
That I went in a certain village where you were studying from.
Jinagenda mchale chimu jenali insomeda.
And I declared the death of witch doctors.
Nenangi dido kufa kwa basamize na hawa logo.
In not more than 3 months.
Mumiaza zichasuke esatu.
8 witch doctors died.
Abasamize munana baafa.
And God used me. There is a woman who had lost a child. That was my senior 4. A lady has lost a child. At 3 at night. There is someone who witnessed that
blight.
He was telling me yesterday, remembering me. The woman had lost a child at 3. And then I went there the next day in the evening. When the child is already dead, you know, someone died at 3 in the hospital, and they took the child back. So
kakati,
they called me to tell them what was happening in their family.
Because
the death of the child was strange. When I reached there, I felt a force to go and resurrect that child. And I said, I want to see that child. When I reached there, I started praying. I started worshipping. In just like not even a minute, the child started crying. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So come to senior 5. I started first
term.
But I felt I should dedicate myself in prayer and fasting than ever before. So the second
term,
I started fasting. I said, this whole time I want to fast. And as continued fasting and praying, I'd reached 1 month and 1 week in senior 5.
Second term.
So the screen came on the wall in my bedroom. In the evening, when I come from the school, there were many words that I couldn't read. But there was a word in quotes that studying and serving me. Decide. The next day, I did not go to school. My mother used to pay school fees in time. So my balance was 30,000. So when she saw that I have not gone to school, the next day she gave me 30,000. So I confused myself as if I've not seen that one.
Kati nefula atalabye sentezo.
When I was going to school, riding a bicycle, I met a woman who looking so bad. And she stopped me. And I stopped. Those who know
Kabale
at Chitumba. So when she stopped me, she asked me, what did God tell you at night? Not greeting me, not doing anything. What did God tell you at night? And she said, for you, you'll be called the priest of Most High God. And people will call you the servant of God. I turned my bicycle to do like this. She disappeared. I continued riding, but you know that fear. When I reached at school, at the gate, I found a man who was from down up to heaven. I looked at him. I got scared. But other students were passing as if there is no person. I was asking, are they going inside him? Are they going inside the
gate?
And he said, enter and die. Or go back and serve me. It was a tough moment to explain someone, I'm the only boy at home. I'm born with two sisters. My sister, one of my sisters is here. You can stand up. This is our first born. Our second born might be somewhere. Yeah. This is our second born. I'm the last born. So I looked as if that the hope of the family is in me. And then I knew that since we are poor because we are a lower standard family, I knew that by all means I have to study and I become something.
But
God said stop. That day when I saw that man, that's when I turned back. And since that time, I did not go to school. But at home, even I feared to go there. Because whenever you'd reach at home, you'd find when they are brought for a counselor. You are walking on the way. You meet another born again. And say,
Otuswaziza,
you are ashamed
of
us. And then I decided to commit more to pray and fast. My home became a bush. I slept in a bush in those mountain years, and it was so much cold for 6 months. I would make sure that maybe they have already left at home. I go back at least during the day. Then at night I sleep in the
bush.
The rain would rain on me. It would rain on me. I remember one day it rained on me until coldness came from my feet and hit my heart and I fall down. And I remember the next day when the shine started shining, I think that's when I started. When I had finished that, you know, the fire had cooled.
Because
6 months the fire had cooled. No one was staying up yet to go to school.
So now,
I said, let me fast 40 days. And I was taking something to drink. I fasted, I don't know what happened to me. Until I started drinking, I would be drinking water. As I'm drinking, it is passing behind. And again, that caused chaos in our family. Because they were saying, I'm killing myself. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God. Because the life I know, I don't know the life before 15 years. But the life I know is after 15 years. When Jesus found me. And every day of my life, I have promised to serve him. This is the my allegiance to him.
Kati chino cha kisubizo change jari mukama katonda.
That again and again.
Nti nera nera.
I will serve him.
Na kumuereza.
So what you have come to celebrate. I celebrate it more than anything.
Kati chamozo kujaguza chijaguzo kusinge chinte chidala chona.
We haven't slept for 3 days.
Ketu neva kako kumane na kusatu.
When Balala and Balala, there was the glory of God. There are people I want to first thank before I pray for your seeds. I want to thank my mother. Let her come here. I normally tell people that I have my best intercessor. She prays for me. Whenever I'm weak, I just make sure that I look the way I tell her. There are some things she tells me that when I was passing through that life, there are days she spent sleeping under my bed.
Waliwe nakuza yasulanga wansi we kitanda change.
Crying.
Ngakaba.
Telling God you gave me one son.
Ngakamba mukama ati wapa kalenzi kamubwe katikatika achibiditi.
Yenda kusimira ruhanga.
I want to thank God for you.
Webale okunshabira.
Thank you for praying for me.
Kandi webale okunkunda.
And thank you for loving me.
Na ninkunda mno.
And I love you so much too.
Wherever I go,
Bulijangenda,
everyone knows that I love my mother.
Buliomachimanyi ntinjagala mama wange.
Thank you very much. Abobwile tindi kuzaku mchanga kaba jirengu hallelujah kushe.
Because of the time I don't want to. I would just want her to say hallelujah to you.
Yeah, bajirengu hallelujah ninga shoba gambire kunava kuromu izina lya Yesu.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen. Hallelujah.
Kama wita simwe.
I thank God so much for this day.
I
had a lot of time of staying to speak, but because of time, thank God. And I pray that God forgives me because I've cried tears.
I said, I have one son.
He has passed through my hand, but he's starting to go. When I gave him school fees and refused to go to school, I felt a lot of pain. I felt a lot of pain. But he kept telling me that mother will give me everything, which even the educated cannot give their true parents. So today when I'm seeing God, what God has done, he revealed them to me. In 2014, he revealed them to me in a scripture. He told me a lot of words which I've been seeing in this place. So I've thanked and appreciated God, and I pray that God forgives me for the many words I spoke. I didn't know that I gave back to a prophet. servant. I did not give birth to a servant of God. I've requested God to forgive me for the negative thoughts I got and the doubt. Amen. May God
Amen.
Bless you, Mama.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. In the journey of the, this ministry, of the ministry.
In my journey of my ministry, I had gone to back to Western. In the journey of my ministry, there are people I want to thank. I had never felt loved.
Nali siulira nga jagadwa.
As someone to know me and understand what I'm doing.
No muntu okumanya nategera chenkola.
I want to call Apostle Christopher.
Jagala kuita omutume Christopher.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I met him in 2008. He was a drunkard.
Yali mutamivu.
Like any other normal person. So we I loved him and he loved me.
Namwagala nanjagala.
And we started the journey together.
Netandiko olugendo fembi.
And he got born again.
Era yalokoka.
After 5 years. For five years he was with me and not born again, but he got born again when after 5 years.
Yamane miaka 5 nange ngasimulokole yalokoka oluvanyuma lw'emyaka egyo 5.
When he got born again,
Boyalokoka.
I explained to him how God has called me.
Namunyo nyola katonda bwampise.
We have passed through pits and hell.
Tuise mubinji ebiwonvu nebiko.
When I would not have what to eat.
Bosabanga na chakulya.
He would run to Kabale.
Yadukanga nagende Kabale.
Onufuso.
Kufuso zinezetiko obumonde.
And at least overlay or do what and bring say you must get what you eat.
Wachi ya hii angana kwa chana chisoboka nande tele chokulia.
By the other time now he has many lands.
Wenjo gede kataina matakamanji na yomurundi guli.
He had one land.
Yaline takalimu.
In Kampala we never knew what to do.
Mukampala tuwate tumaite tuina kola.
And when he saw we have no rent, we have nothing,
tetuina zanju, tetuina chetulina,
he went and sold that land
yagenda natunde takedio yaline elimu
and brought money
naleta sente.
By the way, I looked like there was no hope.
Newe natutulanga tewali wosubiryo na.
He has been with me. Have you ever seen someone to be with a person?
Abade nange mwali mulabye omuntu okubera ne omuntu munne.
Like sometimes you feel you have done longer, he has to judge you. But he will stand and say, no, what is next? What is God saying? When I tell him something, he doesn't bargain. He's a such a son. My sons, I love you. But all of us, if we submit as Apostle Chris, what God promised us. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, the Holy Spirit told me some days back that on this day I give you 1 million. And this 1 million. As God has made me something,
Katonda ngabo amfudde omuntu ekintu kyafudde.
I want to see you rich.
Njagala kula bango gaga wadde.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
can't say much. You have heard this testimony so much. When we had just begun, he got a job. But I would tell him, but why are you bringing all of this? At home there would be everything. He's someone who could forget about his family and remember Timothy. They called him my house boy. He's a graduate.
Yatikirwa.
Now he's an apostle of PG. Hallelujah. God bless you so much. Amen. Amen. Aunt call another person. She doesn't know what she did in my life. You don't know what you did in my life. Aunt Peace. God blow to her as my raven.
Katonda yamuletanga na mungona yange.
The reason why every time you see me reaching time, whether ya, whether what, and I call you.
Ensonga lwaki otuka kasera nga wayise akasera oba mwako oba kine nkukubira.
The time I met you.
Akasera ona kusinkanira.
They had chased us from my house.
Bali batugobye munju.
Of 200,000.
Ya mitwala abiri.
And I had entered in the house of
40,000.
She came when we were in that small church. Few people. When she came and parked, the husband is a justice. So when she came, I was very ashamed. Immediately God showed me his house.
Katonda yandaga enyumba ya makage wegali.
And I said, don't worry. Tomorrow I will come to your house. She said, how do you know?
She
said, I will come. So now,
kakati,
by that very time,
akasera ko kenyini,
you came.
Wacha.
You almost called me every week to come and I pray for you. But I took it that I was not praying for you. Because we didn't have anything. Even coming at your place, I would foot.
Kumanga tetuwali na kantukona no kujewo nyabo na tambu zanga bigere.
And then when I would reach there,
erebwe natuka angayo,
should either give me 70 or 100,000.
Yampanga mitwalo nga musanvu oba 10.
And I would say thank you Jesus.
Era nagamba nganti webale Yesu.
Because this week is over.
Kubanga week eno nayo nji maze wedde.
She fed me when she did not know.
Yandi sanga tachimanyi.
She fed me when she did not know.
Yandi sa mubuta manya.
For like almost 5 months.
Okumala emyezi nge 5.
I called, I wanted her to speak one or two words.
But
no, she doesn't know what she did in my life. The time I started not coming to your praise, I was ashamed even coming there because you didn't know. That me, God had put you to get my lunch, because I was staying with 6 people. You were feeding 6 people. In my church, I would go because we are few. They would give 3,000. Because of anger, I would buy water of 100 Ugandan shillings. We would buy a chapati with Chris. We tear it. We eat the part. And we drink on the same water. Because we are walking from Kawempe to
Machindi.
After fellowship, we go back to Kawempe. Let me not take much of the time. Just
a word.
Mukama simwe.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama simwe abeshemwe.
Praise the Lord, brethren.
I feel like I have no words.
Mpulira nga sirina bigambo.
When I remember the day I met pastor for the first time, I couldn't believe that he was a pastor and he had come to pray. I imagined something else in him.
Konka,
I heard my mother was sick.
Mama wange yali murwadde.
He expected another pastor behind him.
He
started praying.
But yet,
and inside me, I believed in him. Pastor,
thank you for allowing God to use you. Greater and mightier
things.
This is the ministry you're seeing.
You have to dig down.
You people, you cannot find gold on the surface. You have to dig or inna kulima kusima wansi.
Mama,
mother,
thank
you for allowing God to use you as he used Mariam to give birth to Jesus. You didn't know that you could give birth to the servant of God. I also have one son.
Christopher, I will introduce you to my son.
Christopher,
remind me,
you connect, that's where my son works from.
I knew
you thought you had made the loss. You girls, I think you knew you had been born with no one, this child. But God was seeing what is in you. Receive him with two hands.
The
ministry of God and Jesus will reward you. Thanks for honoring me. Thanks for loving me. May God bless you.
May use you more.
And give you more and more and greater and greater. Thank you so much. Because of his prayers, there's also an honor I received. Yes. She's an honorable in the Buganda kingdom.